And there you have it, Blade doing over 200,000 damage in just one turn and is able to clear Memory of Chaos 10 the first half with just one support. Lord Cha, what an absolute beast. Hey everyone, Tomas here, and welcome to another Honkai Star Rail video. So there was a lot of Blade slander early in the days, but my good friend Super Whale is here to show you how insane Blade can be. Of course, this is E6 Blade, alright? This is E6 Blade, and E0 Blade, you can expect some crazy performances as well, but he wanted to show you how strong an E6 Blade with his Comax can do. Now, this is Memory of Chaos 10 with just Blade E6 and an E0 Rocha to keep with his sustain. This combination is absolutely insane. You can see how much damage Blade is already outputting, and every time he drops low from his skill or passive, Lord Cha is there with the heals to help support Blade. You can just see this counter easily does 100,000 in terms of the damage. This is extremely crazy. And the best part is, even the dot damage counts. The dot damage also counts and gives him a stack, and at E6 he only need to reach 4 stacks to do this counter. And look at this, so crazy. And his HP, his max HP is 8k. I'll go over the stats right here. And a quick look at Blade's stat while this is running, and you can see this is not even the optimized build just yet, due to the fact that the new set just came out, and obviously we haven't had a chance to farm for the best set. It's on speed boots, crit damage chest, and the HP rope, as well as the wind damage orb. That's kind of what we're running. You can see the bonus is really, really built for Blade, and this is the stat line base needed for him to do his work. We've got Lord Cha here as well, and here are his stats. But let's take a look at how the run progresses. But you can see how amazing Blade's Eidolon synergizes with the rest of his kit. I have an E6 Asane myself, but looking at the performance of the E6 Blade, I am strongly considering pulling and dipping into my Kafka fund for Blade. This is absolutely crazy. Huge win for the Husbando lovers. Look at this crazy damage. It's always basically an attack into either filling your ultimate gauge or your 4 stacks to trigger the follow-up attack. And oh my god, look at this. Oof, that is about 70,000 into the ultimate, which is listed for 130,000, and drops low, and Lord Cha automatically heals. And because Lord Cha's passive is triggering so frequently, you're going to have the flower field up all the time, and even if Blade gets crowd control like here, Lord Cha will be able to help and dispel as well. So when things all go well, Blade can at one turn output about 200,000 damage. This is in comparison to our best DPS at the moment, which is a single target Sele, right? Look at this, 138,000. Oh my god, this is in comparison to Sele. And Sele does that insane amount of damage from the passive triggering, but Blade is able to just achieve that. So what a crazy performance from Blade. Now, taking a look at Blade's maxed Super Imposition 5 Lycon, it just offers way too much. A 30% crit rate increase, a 30% max HP increase, and on top of that, another 40% damage buff. Oh my god, how much more text can you cram in just one cone? Now, looking at the Eidolons, I really think even at E0, Blade is going to put in so much work. If you got Lord Cha, then this is the perfect combination, and later on you can add in units like Bronya, standard non-limited unit, to make Blade even stronger. I'll make a team guide video on that at a later time, but let's take a look at Eidolon's, why E6 Blade is just a different beast altogether. Now, E1 boosts the ultimate damage, was great. E2 provides a 15% crit rate. This is why Blade can reach really high crit rate if you have the cone as well as the passive from the E2 with nothing else, right? All he has to do is enter Hellscape state. If you compare that with Sele, Sele gets a 15% crit rate boost as well, but the enemy has to be at 80% HP or less. Now, Blade just has to be in his Hellscape state, which he is going to be pretty much 90% of the time, if not 100. So this is a free 15% crit rate. Now looking at the E4, this is where things get crazy. When Blaze HP falls to 50% or lower of the max HP, you get a 20% max HP boost. And remember, his skills, his ultimate, they all revolve around his max HP. And you can see why this blade had, I think, 7,000 HP. But when this triggers, he gets about 8,500, right? Due to this E4 passive. Again, it stacks up to 2x. Now E6. E6 is where Blade's damage just shoots right through the roof. You've got your charge stack, max charge stack required to trigger that follow-up attack reduced to 4. So instead of 5, it's 4. So it's already pretty much a 20% increase from that regard. And then you also get a 50% increase of the follow-up attack based on the max HP, right? So max HP, let's say 8,000 after you get all of these stacks going, that's basically a 4,000 bonus. Oh my goodness, Blade absolutely cracked. Now, for me personally, as you guys know, I'm a huge Kafka lover, right? I played this game because I saw Kafka and I definitely want Kafka. But after testing this Mega Whale's Blade, my naked Kafka is slowly turning into the naked Blade. Let me know your thoughts. Should I be dipping into my Kafka fund to max Blade, be a husbando chaser, a meta slave, or did I stay true to what I had in the beginning and go and pull for that naked Kafka E6 Cone 5? Let me know your thoughts, because honestly, like I said on stream before, super undecided now with how strong Blade is. Honestly, I would say at Sele level. Anyhow, it's Demise here. Let me know your thoughts. Comment down below. Now, see you guys in the next video. Goodbye now.